Alright, speaking of voting, who here watched all four nights of the Democratic presidential debates? Okay, one person, not just me, good, you never know. Well, don't worry, it's okay if you didn't. I watched them, so you don't have to. So, we got the third debate coming up this Thursday, and so I'm gonna put together a little medley here to get you all caught up on America's most boring reality show. Here we go! We've been screwed up by Trump again and again. Wondering every day just when it will end. Look at us now, will we ever learn? I don't know how, but we gotta make Trump get gone. Time to pick who will take him on. 20 Dems got up there on that stage. 10 per night for some hardcore exchange. Whoa, campaign season, here we go again. My, time to really wonk out. Campaign season, this roadshow again. That is, if I don't just conk out. Yes, we've been broken hearted. Blue since Trump's term has started. But now, from 20, we must choose one. All these options, how we gonna pick? Good thing I don't vote for 8 more months. Okay, first night of the first debate, or first debate in general, here we go. So, the first thing that I noticed was the amount of Spanish that was just getting thrown around, whether or not it was necessary or made any sense in context. They're in immigration, Latinx votes to convict. So they'll try speaking Spanish with a really bad accent. It'll make you wonder if they just pick words to memorize. Were they speaking off the cuff or did they just recite? In a fight for a sound bite, come on! Beto Booker, yeah! Look at them, they speak Spanish. Como te llama? Look at them, they speak Spanish. Growing up hearing Spanish. Their peep wasn't too bad. Just one line said in Spanish. Then we have Marianne Williamson, a cookie candidate straight out of a 70s now rally, who actually makes good points sometimes and then ruins it by talking about dark psychic forces. I am woman, hear me roar. You shouldn't have let me through the door. Cause every time I speak, I sound a bit. But I'll keep coming back for more, with odd ramblings galore, till you raise the standards for the third debate. Then we have our own Bill de Blasio making a pass on himself. New Yorkers sometimes can be rough, when we don't get to say enough. Mayor Bill can't help but interrupt. Most people wish he'd just shut up. Yakety yak, don't do that. But of course, the big story out of the first debate was Kamala Harris's absolute smackdown of Joe Biden, very effectively using her own personal story with desegregation to challenge his record from the 70s. Well, this woman's really great. She's really great. Got amazing presence up there, Kamala. She's got Biden on the run. On the run, got him set under your stare, Kamala. Never let it up till his argument is down to crumbs. I can't wait to see you do the same thing to Donald Trump. My, whoa! Damn, Kamala. Alright, so the first debate. Now we got the second debate, when after Kamala's big success, everyone decided going after Joe Biden was the way to go. You keep saying you're the best one for us, but your poll numbers just won't leave the ground. In this debate, you really gotta get attention. What better way than smacking the beep around? They all want a shot at Biden, so that's just what they'll do. Hoping if Biden falls down, one of them might just break through.
And what was Biden's response to all these attacks on how his past actions had harmed minorities?
My black friend, remember Barack, you all think he's so great, and because he loves me, forget anything I did before 2008. My black friend is a shield against all my prior sins, so
to get to higher ground. But of course, the real winner of the second debate was Elizabeth Warren, who had the best line of the night when she told some cranky moderate, "I don't know why people go to all the trouble for running for president just to talk about what we can't really do and shouldn't fight for. Freaking mic drop." She and Bernie stood together back to back, fighting against all these cranky white moderates for their progressive agenda.
And we can build this dream together, stand against the center, nothing's gonna stop us now. Let them say our plans are absurd, we'll still have the last word, nothing's gonna stop us.
Third debate is just how many white men are running. I mean, this was the most diverse field in history, and we still had 17 white guys decide to run. And though some of them have dropped out, we still got 11 of them in the race, and most of them didn't even make it into the third debate. I mean, if you are not one of what I call the four V's, which is Bernie, Bido, Beto, and Buttigieg, what are you even still doing here?
Won't you drop out? You don't really have a chance to win. It's just kind of pointless. We don't need any more mediocre white men. Now I know that in the 90s you would be a certainty. But that's over now. Make way for diversity.